I'm talking to you about something else. The security of your country. We need to know. Don't go Boy Scout on me. We don't have a rule book here.
Your agent, Hoffman, yeah?
Yeah.
German extraction.
Yeah, so?
My name's Donovan. Irish, both sides. Mother and father. I'm Irish. You're German. But what makes us both Americans? Just one thing. One. The rule book. We call it the Constitution, and we agree to the rules, and that's what makes us Americans.
Tom Hanks joins a really wonderful line of recipients of the Records of Achievement Award. We think he is perfect because he personifies a person who has the courage and the creativity to make American history compelling. Through his movies, through his documentaries, through his acting, through his directing, he really takes these difficult and challenging and compelling stories and shows you the drama, shows the emotion of these stories, helps us as Americans identify with these characters and with these periods of time.
Tom's a very proud American. This is his culture. American history speaks to him as an individual.
Tom's so well read, you know, and he reads biographies more than he reads fiction. And he's been that way ever since I've ever known him.
When we were approached by Tom to tell the story of the Apollo space program, it became clear to us that if you were working with people who had a deep and abiding commitment, telling the great stories of Americana, that you not only could do something which made a difference in terms of informing your citizenry, but you could create tremendous popular entertainment. So you could do well and do good at the same time.
I first met Tom in a small breakfast cafe in Ketchum, Idaho. And he said, I read your book and I love your book. Well, almost every producer I've ever sat down to talk with has said that. He said, but I have a few things I'd like to ask you. And with that, he reached down on the floor and picked up a copy of my book, which was a flutter with post-its.
I think audiences crave more and more detail. And it's up to storytellers to deliver projects that ring true, projects that resonate, projects that earn the audience's respect.
My judgment approves this measure, and my whole heart is in it. All that I have, all that I am, and all that I hope in this life, I am now ready to stake upon it. While I live, let me have a country. A free country.
So I think Tom brings that passion. It becomes infectious. He's a deeply informed citizen. And I think he recognizes that he has this unique opportunity to take his celebrity and his expertise and to tell the great stories about what makes our country what it is. And I think we're at HBO extremely blessed to have a partnership with somebody like that.
I think what makes Tom Hanks work, whether he's producing a project of his own or whether he's acting, is he has the capacity of empathy.
Ryan, I don't know anything about Ryan. I don't care. Man means nothing to me, it's just a name. But if, you know, if going to Rommel and finding him so he can go home, if that earns me the right to get back to my wife, well then that's my mission.
You know, it's safe to say that Private Ryan fed into a whole new interest by the American public, actually worldwide, about the United States' role in World War II. His movies create a renewed interest in aspects of our history, which is great for us because it gives us an opportunity to celebrate and use our records to support the messages that are coming through in his films.
They came back to us a few years later after they had read Stephen Ambrose's seminal book, Band of Brothers, and say, look, we want to tell the story of the camaraderie and brotherhood of what it meant to be a soldier, story of American patriotism and heroism, and to do so in a way which I think informed a generation of young people who may not have been aware of the story of the Greatest Generation. And Band of Brothers exceeded even our expectations of just how compelling and resonant this storytelling can be.
Sure clean up good.
Yeah. All he needs is a little Mozart.
Beethoven.
Sorry, sir.
That's not Mozart. That's Beethoven.
The first true story that I ever worked on as a motion picture was Apollo 13. I was very much influenced by Tom Hanks's love of the space program, but also his integrity surrounding the storytelling. He kept saying, we don't have to make this stuff up. Let's just keep reading. Let's just keep talking and understanding. We literally built scenes around flight transcripts, and they became some of the most dramatic and sort of palpably riveting scenes in the whole movie.
Hey.
This is Houston. Say again, please.
Houston, we have a problem.
It was truly inspiring for me. In fact, by the time we're ready to shoot a movie, I have so many photos, color Xeroxes. I've got documentaries playing on video screens. You cannot walk from any office without walking down a hall that is informing you of what the truth of the story must feel like.
If you love history and you love the study of history, and in our case, the illumination of history through our medium, the National Archives is a seminal place to preserve, protect, and defend, because we can't tell our history without it.
So The Bridge of Spies is a good one because it was made possible by the declassification of records in the National Archives. So a lot of that story had not been told before, could not have been told before, because those records were classified. So that's another role that I think the National Archives plays in terms of telling the story of our history.
I think Tom Hanks really respects the original records. He respects the primary sources, and those primary sources live here in the National Archives. He brings an integrity to his storytelling.
Tom loves playing both the authentic, which has its limitations, and the unfettered, which gives him great pleasure. Both Donovan, the character he played in Bridge of Spies, and Captain Miller in Saving Private Ryan are both very principled men who believe in doing the best they can to do the right thing.
I think he's one of the most remarkable, talented, good-hearted, energetic Americans I've ever known. And I look up to him with great respect and in friendship.
There's so many things I've learned from Tom, so many things I admire about Tom that I've taken to work with me with other actors in other films. But the five films that Tom and I have made together have been, basically, it's been a confirmation of our deep friendship and of our abiding love for the subjects that we both choose to tell stories about, and has just enormously increased my respect for him and one of the greatest icons we have in this nation.
I had a neighbor growing up. One day I heard a bunch of yelling from across the street, so I ran over to Mr. Hazard's, and there were about 15 grown-ups standing around my dog. Mr. Hazard ground up a glass bottle and put on a bowl of dog food and fed it to me. And then I remembered Mr. Hazard was an elected official. He was head of the town council. His re-election every 2 years was a foregone conclusion. So come election day, about 400 ballots were cast in that election. I drove 96 of them to the polls. Hazard lost by 16 votes. And that's the day I fell in love with America.